snowflake. On a cold and grey Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in a ghetto. And his mama cried, 'cause one thing that she doesn't need is another hungry mouth to feed in a ghetto. People don't understand, the child needs a helping hand, or he'll grow up with an anger on man someday. Take a look at you and me, are we too blind to see? Or simply do we turn our heads and look the other way when the world turns? And a hungry little boy with a runny nose plays in the street as the cold wind blows in the ghetto. And a hunger burns. And he starts to run the streets at night. He learns how to steal and he learns how to fight in the ghetto. Then one night in desperation, the young man breaks away. He buys a gun, steals a car, tries to run, but he don't get far. And his mama cries. And a crowd goes round and anger on him, face down in the streets when he's running his hand in a ghetto. And the young man dies. On a cold and grey Chicago morn, another little baby child is born in a ghetto. Well, how did they pluck us out of Sore Things again with a real classic song from Elvis Presley this time, of course, in the ghetto, obviously. Sorry about the singing. Apologies to all you Elvis fans out there, but this is just for reference, okay. So I'm in standard tuning, but I do have a capo on the first fret. Puts us into the same key as the original version by Elvis Presley, so be to play along with his record, okay. Now for this record I'm actually using my fingers, okay. Obviously ideally you probably need a nylon strings as well to give it that sort of soft sound, okay, but obviously I've still got my steel strings on, but I am using my fingers to try and soften it down. And also the main riff of the song, it's difficult to play with a pick to make it sound any good, so I'm using my fingers, okay. So let's get to it. So the main thing about this song is, not chord wise it's very simple, fairly straightforward, but the main thing is this riff, which you have to get your head round, okay. That, which is goes all the way through the song, okay. Right then, so let's get to it. So I'm starting off with a lazy A, okay. So I'm using my first finger to bar the fourth, third and second strings on the second fret from the capo, okay. Lazy A. Then I'm using my thumb and three fingers for this, okay. My pinky doesn't do anything in this really, okay. So what I'm doing is I'm hitting the open fifth string with my thumb, then I'm hitting the fourth string with my thumb, right. Then I'm plucking the fourth, third and second strings on the bar on the second fret with three fingers all at the same time, all three strings plucked at the same time. So you got, as soon as you've plucked the three fingers, you hit the open string on the fifth string again. You hit it with your thumb, pluck the open fifth string again. Alright? And then what we do, right, this is where the fun starts. As soon as you've done that open fifth string with your thumb, you pluck the open, the A chord again, the 4th, 3rd and 2nd strings again, all at the same time with your 3 fingers. So it's... Okay. But after, so immediately you've plucked those 3 strings, you hammer into that shape. That. Okay. Keeping the first finger fretted, you hammer in to the 3rd fret of the 2nd string from the capo with your 2nd finger, and also at the same time the 4th fret of the 4th string with your 3rd finger. Just the 4th, 3rd and 2nd strings pluck. It should sound like that. Okay? So now what we've got is this so far. So let's start again, sorry. Okay? The first bit I can show you. Okay, now what happens now is immediately you've hammered up, you take those fingers off, hit the A string open again with your thumb. So now you've got this. Alright, actually, you could leave it there for a second, you could leave those fretted hammer-ons if you wanted to. Hit the open A string with your thumb, then take those fingers off. Because immediately you've hit that open A string again, you repeat the hammer-on, plucking the 4th, 3rd and 2nd strings on the bar, and hammer back up again like you did just now. Another one of those, okay? So now you've got this. Do that. And now we do that again. So immediately you've hammered up for the second time, you hit the A string open with your thumb. So that's good so far. Then hit the open A string, and then you do another one of these. So now you've got 3 of those, okay? Slowly. Okay. Again, immediately you've hammered up, you hit the A string again with your thumb. Now we've got this. That's right. Right, but this time it's different. The last time it's different. You hit the open A string, then you hit that 4th string again with your thumb. 2nd fret on the bar, just like you did it right at the beginning. Okay, so now you've got this. Okay, and then what we do is we do another hammer, open that on the 4th, 3rd and 2nd strings again, so you've got that. So after you've done the 4th string, 5th string, sorry, on the 4th string, another hammer up, hit the open 5th string again. Now you've got this. Okay, then you hit the open 5th string again. And this time you keep those 2 fingers fretted and hit, you pluck the 4th, 3rd and 2nd strings again with them already fretted. So you don't hammer into it, they just keep it there from the last hammer. So now on your fret, so you pluck those 3 with those 2 fingers already in place, so you don't hammer into it. And then finally, let's just get to that far, hang on. Right. And then the final one is just the open bar, 4, 3 and 2. So, if I do it slowly, right, that last bit is, that goes, okay, we You could hammer into it twice, but I think it varies. Sometimes he does it, sometimes he doesn't. That's a simpler version of it. So the whole thing. Right, so hopefully you've got that. Obviously it does take a bit of practice, okay? It's not easy. So let's just go through that again very slowly, okay? So open fifth, fourth, and then the three, fourth, third and second strings with the bar. Open fifth string, hammer, open fifth string, hammer, open fifth string, hammer, open fifth string, fourth string, hammer, open fifth string, then those fretted ones this time, and then just the bar of three. So play with that. Okay, so the song starts off with that, obviously, and then when you finish doing that, he comes in and sings "As the Snow Flies," and you do it again. Okay. As the snow flies. So you do it twice, and in between the two you do that "As the Snow Flies." Not easy to get that in either to start with. As the snow flies. Right, now comes the easier part of the song, the verse. It goes up to C sharp minor. So that's four frets from the capo minor shape. You can either do a simple version or a bar chord. On a cold and grey Chicago morn, D, the poor little baby, E, child is born. And then we do the riff again in the ghetto. And his mama cries. Let's do that whole thing very slowly up to that point, okay? From the beginning. And snow flies. On a cold and cloudy Chicago morn, a poor little baby child is born on a ghetto. And then we do another verse again, C sharp minor, because there's one thing that she don't need, D, E, have to feed, and the riff again, ghetto. But you only do it once, you don't do it twice, okay? So, in the ghetto, and he does the next part of the song, "People, don't you understand?" And on "understand," it's E, okay? "Don't you understand? The child needs a D, helping A hand. Or D, he'll grow up to be a angry young man someday." So we just go through it again, coming after the riff. "People, don't you unease and shall be D, a help A in hand D, or he'll grow up to be a E, angry on my A someday. E, take a look at you and E, or D, or we blind A, C." Now we do single strums. D, C, C sharp minor, turn our head, or B minor, look, the other E way. So that last line is D, C sharp minor, easy version, pause, bar chord, B minor, two frets down, second fret minor shape, simple one, or a bar chord, and then an E chord. So that's from the previous, where it goes in the ghetto, going into this bit, okay, in the ghetto. People don't you uneat, D, child, A, B man, D, real good, E, England, A, C, E, real good, you, me, D, are we deep, A to C, D, simply done, C sharp minor, B minor, look the other way. Well, and then back to the riff. Then we do just one of those, and then we're off into another verse again. A hundred of a boy with a runny nose plays in the street as a boat goes on a ghetto. And it's hunger birds again. And a verse he starts to roam the streets at night, learns how to steal and learns how to fight in a ghetto. Just once. Never a middle bit, then one night day, no sorry, then one night in desperation, the young man breaks away, D, grabs a gun, steals a car, tries to run, and the E, looking for riff, and then mother cries. Another verse, found out of there, like a young man, D, E, was there, get out of riff, twice. Man dies. Verse on a cold and gray Chicago. Another little baby child is born on a riff. And there you have it. So once you've got the first half of the song, basically it just repeats again. It's just getting the arrangement in your head. Okay, so there you have it, boys and girls. Hopefully that will help you play that song. The hardest thing obviously is the chord riff thing. That, okay. Well, just practice, okay. Just practice it. Thanks very much for watching and listening, and I'll see you in the next lesson. Bye for now.